5,000 with 5 loaves and 2 fishes.
John the Baptizer declared him to be the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. How can he be dead?
We saw him raise the sick.
Heal the lame.
He raised Lazarus from the dead.
But we saw him crucified.
And now his body's gone.
His body. Where can he be? What has happened?
I don't know.
My friends, what is this you are discussing so intently?
Have you not heard all that has happened to Jerusalem these last few days?
What has happened?
Have you not heard about Jesus? Jesus of Nazareth, a man who was a prophet, mighty indeed before God and all of the people.
Jesus, who was delivered by our chief priests and rulers to be condemned to death, death by crucifixion.
We thought that Jesus would be the one who would deliver Israel.
Today, the women in our company told us something amazing.
Early this morning, when they went to the tomb, they found it empty. And then they saw a vision of angels who told them, Jesus is alive.
Some of the men ran to the tomb. They found it just as the women had said. But they did not find Jesus.
Oh, foolish ones, and slow of heart. Slow of heart to believe and see that all the prophets have spoken. God our Father has always had a great deliverer, and he has always loved his people. But to redeem mankind, was it not necessary for Christ to suffer these things and then enter into his glory? Come, let us look at the scriptures from the beginning. And we will see the Messiah foretold.
Keeping his true identity hidden from them, Jesus continued to walk and talk to the two men, explaining all that was written in the scriptures concerning his coming. From the books of Moses to the prophets, he spoke of how he had fulfilled every prophecy, beginning in Genesis. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Thank you.
And God saw all that he had created above, upon, and below the earth, and saw that it was good. Then God said,
Let us make man in our image.
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them.
Express the strength of love.
God created both male and female, and saw that it was very good. All was good in the Garden of Eden, until one dark day, when the serpent, the most cunning of all creatures in the garden, appeared.
Eve, has God not said ye shall eat of every tree in the garden?
We may eat the fruit of any of the trees in the garden, except for the tree in the center of the garden. God told us not to eat from it. We aren't even to touch it or we'll die.
Did God say that? Nay, he shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day that ye eat thereof, that your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and knowing evil. Is not this tree good for food? Is it not pleasing to thine eye? Dost thou not desire to be wise?
When the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it brought delight to the eyes, and was desirable to make one wise, she took from its fruit and ate. And she gave some to her husband that was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both of them were opened. Because Adam and his wife Eve chose to disobey God, they were banished from the Garden of Eden. Yet, the omniscient, loving God already had a plan to redeem them and all of mankind. For the first time since the beginning of creation, blood was shed as the Lord God made garments of animal skins to cover the sins of his beloved. Over 2,000 years had come and gone since the fall of man. Yet a plan for the redemption of mankind had been upon the heart and mind of God since eternity past. God made a covenant with a man named Abram, a man who was childless, yet by faith was fully convinced that God was able to do what he had promised. God changed Abram's name to Abraham, signifying that he would be the father of a multitude. And at the age of 100, Abraham fathered Isaac. The broken fellowship between a holy God and his creation was to be restored through one of Abraham's descendants. Yet Abraham's faith would be tested in a way that seemed to defy the very covenant spoken from the mouth of God. As Abraham's unquestioning faith and God's sovereign provision converged on Mount Moriah, it foreshadowed a day when God would provide once again. But this time his provision would be the sign of a new and perfect covenant. A deliverer was coming. And his sacrifice would take place in the shadow of that very mount, more than 2,000 years after Abraham's faith was displayed.
journey to the sacred place. A boy and a man with a sorrowful face, tortured yet faithful to God's command, to take the life of his son with his own hand. God will provide a lamb to be offered up in your place, a sacrifice so spotless and clean to take all your sin away. Here's wood and fire, where's the sacrifice? The questioning voice and the innocent eyes. Is the son of laughter who you've waited for to die like a lamb to please the Lord? God will provide a lamb to be offered up in your place, a sacrifice so spotless and clean to take all your sin accepted choice, a rush of wind and the angel's voice, a ram in the thicket caught by his horns, and a new age of trusting the Lord is born. God has provided a lamb, he was offered up in your place. What Abraham was asked to do, he's done. He's offered his only son. What Abraham was asked to do, he's done. He's offered his only.
Many generations followed after Abraham, and when God's people found themselves in the land of Egypt, the Lord provided for them. The sons of Israel greatly increased and multiplied in number, so much that the Israelites outnumbered the Egyptians. In fear, the new Pharaoh condemned the sons of Israel to mortar and brick pits, and they became bitter. Groaning in their slavery, they cried out to God for deliverance.
Thank you.
The Lord God heard the brokenhearted cries from his people, and he delivered them by sending one of their own, Moses, to lead them out of Egypt toward the land the Lord had promised them. God would speak his word to his people through kings, judges, and prophets, but the people chose not to hear his words, and because of this, they would pay a great price. For 400 years, God was silent as they endured wars, political strife, and the onslaught of pagan religions. Down to their last hope, the chosen people of God remembered the promise of the coming Messiah, prophesied to be God's only son, and how he would take on the garments of human flesh to dwell among them. At the appointed time, God sent his messenger Gabriel to Mary, a young virgin, to announce his plan for the salvation of mankind. After the angel Gabriel revealed God's glorious plan to Mary and later to Joseph, the time had come for a census to be taken. Every man was called to his own town to be registered. Joseph, along with Mary, went up from Nazareth into the city of David, called Bethlehem, because Joseph was of the house and lineage of David. While they were there, the time came for Mary to give birth. And because there was no room for them in the inn, the baby, the Savior of the world, was born in a stable. Mary wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger.
Oh,
For the shepherds, seeing was believing. So after seeing Mary and Joseph and seeing the baby lying in a manger, the shepherds returned to their fields, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, just as it had been told to them.
Our songs
songs of praise to thee.
Messiah had been born, but only a few had been invited to witness this amazing event. 30 years would come and go before God's plan of salvation would be introduced to a lost and dying world. Many were still looking for a deliverer, not knowing he was already among them.
Joseph took his wife and child, and they went to to escape the rage of a deadly king. Growing from a babe to a child, Jesus heard the joyful song that the captive children used to sing. They were singing, "My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. Magi come the promised king, bringing gifts to lay before his feet. Understanding who he was, Jesus heard the whole world cry for the hope that one day he'd fulfill.
Son of John, you shall be called Peter.
Lord, go away from me, for I'm a sinful man.
Do not fear me, Peter. From now on, you will all be fishers of men. Come, follow me.
He had come, Messiah had come. Rejoice, daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king comes unto thee.
Rejoicing over you with songs of gladness, singing joyfully, he will say. just
be just.
Daughters of Zion, shout aloud, Israel, rejoice with all your heart, O Jerusalem. Daughters of Zion, shout aloud, Israel, rejoice with all your heart, O Jerusalem.
Roni!
Roni, Roni, Vahazion, Arihu, Israel, Tivalzi, Holem, Bat Yerushalayim, Bat Yerushalayim, Bat Yerushalayim.
The Feast of Unleavened Bread, the Passover, was quickly approaching. Fearful of losing control of the people, the priests and scribes were desperately discussing ways to have Jesus put to death. Then Satan entered into the heart of Judas Iscariot, one of the 12.
This situation with the Nazarene is getting out of control.
Did you see his entry into the city? They gave him the welcome of a king.
Jesus must be arrested and done away with.
It cannot happen during the festival.
The people will riot.
We will keep that in mind.
Who are you, and why do you seek counsel with a high priest?
I am Judas Iscariot. I am one of Jesus's 12.
What information do you have that can help us?
I know his teachings, I know his followers. Yeah. I know where he is staying. I know where he goes to be alone. Yes, I know where he will be alone. And I will take you to him.
Why would you help us? You are one of his followers.
No! I used to believe in his foolish coming kingdom. But now, what is my reward if I hand him over to you?
We will give you 30 pieces of silver to deliver him to us.
He is planning on having the Passover meal with his disciples. I have to be there or that so-called Messiah will suspect something. But after the meal, I will bring you to him.
Jesus, the great prophet and teacher, sold for the price of a slave.
Alone with his disciples in the upper room, Jesus was preparing to take the Passover meal. Knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and would return to God, he got up, took a towel, and girded himself.
Do you know what I have done for you? You call me Lord and teacher, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, washed your feet, you should also do as I have done for you. I know the ones that I have chosen, yet truly, truly I say to you, that one of you will betray me.
But Lord, who is it?
It is the one for whom I shall dip the morsel and give it to him. Judas, what you do, do quickly.
Thank you.
I have earnestly desired to share this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say unto you now, I shall never eat it again until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Take, drink all of it. This cup is the new covenant of my blood, which is poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Little children, I am only with you a little while longer. You will seek me, but where I am going, you cannot come.
But Lord, where are you going?
Where I am going, you cannot follow now, but you will follow later.
Why can I not follow you now? I would lay down my life for you.
Will you, Peter? Will you really lay down your life for me? Truly, truly, I say to you, the rooster will not crow until you have denied me three times.
Never, Lord. Look, two swords.
Enough, Peter. Enough. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. I am going to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also.
Lord, we don't know where you are going. So how can we know the way?
Thomas, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. I have spoken these things to you so you may have peace. In this world you will have many troubles, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. My hour has come. Let us go to the garden and pray. Come, let us go.
Sit here and watch while I pray. Peter, James, and John, come with me. My soul is deeply grieved to the point of death. Remain here with me and keep watch. Watch and pray. Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that he also may glorify you. You have given him all authority. Over all things. Shelter me, Father. Abba! If you can see any other way, and you are willing, let this cup pass from me. Are you still sleeping? Could you not watch and pray with me even for 1 hour? Keep watching and praying, that you may not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Abba! Daddy! I have given them the words you gave me to give to them. And I know that all things are possible with you. Ah.
Abba! Yet not my will, but your will be done. Your will be done. Shelter me, Father. My heart is ready. My heart is ready. Are you still resting? Enough! Rise up! The Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. For behold, my betrayer is here.
Hail, Rabbi!
Judas, you betray the Son of Man with a kiss?
I am Malchus, servant of Caiaphas. Are you Jesus of Nazareth?
I am. If you are looking for me, then let these men go. No more of this!
Oh, my ear!
Put your sword away, Peter. All who live by the sword will die by the sword. Do you not know? Do you not know that I can call on my Father, and he will send me 12 legions of angels? But if I did that, how would the scriptures be fulfilled? And why? Why do you come at me with your swords and clubs to arrest me like a criminal? Every day I was with you in the temple, and you did not lay your hands on me. But what the scriptures say must come to pass.
Arrest them! Arrest them all! What are the charges brought against this man? Do we have a witness?
He claimed he would destroy the temple
and build it again in 3 days.
His teachings are different from ours.
You do not answer. What is it that these men are testifying against you? Are you the Christ? Tell us! Are you the Messiah, the Son of God?
I am.
Blasphemy! You have heard his testimony. How does it seem to you? He deserves death.
He is guilty.
Guilty! Enough. Take him to Pilate.
Why have you brought this man back to me? I have already examined him and not found him guilty of any charges. Nor has Herod, for he sent him back to me. Nothing he has done deserves death. Therefore, I shall have him whipped and then released.
The people demand his death. What is your response to them?
Punish him yourselves.
We would, great Pilate, but it is against your laws for us to put a man to death.
Are you the king of the Jews?
Are you asking this on your own? Or have others told you about me?
I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation delivered you to me.
My kingdom is not of this world.
So? You are a king.
You say correctly that I am a king. And for this reason I was born. And for this reason I have come into this world. To testify to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice.
What is truth? Still, I find no fault in him.
I must speak with you. I beg you, have nothing to do with this righteous man. The last night I suffered greatly in a dream because of him. Please.
I am prefect here. I have no choice. I have an idea. Centurion, bring to me the murderous thief that we arrested this past week. Barabbas, I think they call him. I will give the people a choice. Of course, given the choice of Jesus over Barabbas, they will certainly choose Jesus over a condemned murderer. People of Judea, I have made every effort over the years to work together with you for peace.
No, he has not. He has not.
As you know, it is my custom every year at Passover to release one prisoner to you. But today, I give you a choice. Barabbas. Guilty of murder, insurrection, and robbery. Or Jesus, in whom I find no fault. Whom would you have me release? Well, then what would you have me do with Jesus? I find no fault in him! Centurion, release Barabbas. As for Jesus, I am innocent of this man's blood. See to that yourselves. Away with him. Let him be crucified.
Let his blood be on us and on our children! Crucify him!
They stripped him and beat him, and on him they placed a scarlet robe. Twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head. They knelt before him in mockery, and having mocked him, they led him away to be crucified.
Beating, there were stripes upon his back.
Woman, behold your son. John, behold your mother.
Well then, Son of God, come down from the cross, if you can.
Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
He saved others, but he cannot save himself.
If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself.
No, you're not the Christ. Save yourself and us.
Do you not fear God? We are receiving the punishment that we deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
I tell you truly, today you will be with me in paradise. My God! My God! Why have you forsaken me? Into your hands I commit my spirit. It is finished.
The Son of God.
Centurion, this has gone on long enough. Pilate promised...
I know what Pilate has promised you. You, make sure that he is dead.
Thank you.
Caiaphas, what are you doing here? Have I not done enough for you?
Sir, we remembered that while Jesus was still alive, he said, in 3 days, I will rise again.
What do you want from me, high priest?
We would ask that you give the order that the tomb be sealed and guarded until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may come and steal the body and claim he has risen from the dead.
You have your guard of soldiers. Go and do as you've requested.
Sir, the tomb has been sealed.
Good. Take your guard.
Sir, why have we been posted here?
The chief priests went to Pilate and reported before his death. Jesus said that he would rise from the dead in 3 days. They believed that the disciples will steal the body and claim he's risen.
Guard a tomb? Sir, you really don't
what
believe.
What I now believe does not matter. We do what we're told, or we pay the consequences. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Shuffling of soldiers' feet as they guarded the grave. 1 day, 2 days, 3 days had passed. Could it be that Jesus had breathed his last? Could it be that his Father had forsaken him, turned his back on his son, despising our sin? All hail seemed to whisper, just forget him, he's dead. Then the Father looked down to his son and
no more suffering.
first day of the week, at early dawn, the women went to the tomb, taking with them the spices they had prepared.
Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified.
He is risen. He is not here. Behold, the place where they've laid him.
Jesus is alive. Now go and tell his disciples and Peter.
I suffered and died and rose for you, Tammy. For you, Brock. For you, Latoya. For you, Avery. I suffered and died and rose for you, Wade. For you, Josh. I suffered and died and rose for everybody in here.
As the two men from Emmaus approached their village, they noticed that Jesus appeared to be going further. Wanting to speak with him more, they implored him to join them for supper. When Jesus reclined at the table with them, he took the bread and blessed it, and breaking it, he gave it to them. Suddenly, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. In that same instant, Jesus vanished from their sight.
He vanished before our very eyes. It is Jesus, our Lord.
Yes.
Were not our hearts burning within us?
Oh, yes. While he was explaining the scriptures to us.
Quickly, we must tell all that we have seen and heard.
We must tell him Jesus is alive.
He's alive. Jesus is alive.
We've seen Jesus. We've seen him. Jesus is alive.
The two men got up that very hour and returned to Jerusalem and found that others had gathered there. While they were speaking to one another, Jesus appeared to them.
Everything written about me in the prophets were true. In the book of Psalms, in the law of Moses, everything written about me is true. I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. Go therefore to all the nations and make them my disciples.
God.